Respected Professor A.K. Gupta, Professor Malik and Dr. Sri Ramamurthy, it is a great honor for me and I am thankful to All India Ophthalmological Society and Scientific Committee for giving me this prestigious opportunity. I will be speaking on posterior capsular opacification, the most common cause of visual impairment after successful surgery. As you can see that this is posterior capsular opacification. Posterior capsular opacification, and this is clear visual axis. And this is an honor for me because it is a Dr. P. Shiva Reddy award, and Professor P. Shiva Reddy was a great man. He was a Padma Bhushan awardee, crusader of cataract blindness in the country. He conducted more than 500 eye camps and operated more than 3 lakhs cataract operations. And I bow my head to my teacher, Professor Iyer Jain and Professor Amod Gupta, who taught me ophthalmology, and other colleagues like Dr. Dogra, they supported me. And equally important for me is Professor David J. Apple, with whom I worked in 1993-94 and 1998, and we analyzed the largest database of the world. In 1992 and before, the incidence of PCO was between 30% to 50%. But in 1998, meta-analysis by Schomburg et al. Shows that still the rate of PCO after 5 years after cataract surgery was still greater than 25%. Our several studies showed that PCO rates were between 2.2% to 25%. With different IOL material and designs. Why it is important to eradicate posterior capsular opacification? First, the modern cataract surgery is a refractive procedure and patient expect best visual outcome. Second, there are numerous complications with when we have to deal the posterior capsular opacification with ND-YAG laser capsulotomy. They are cystoid macular edema, retinal detachment, secondary glaucoma, IOL damage. Third, the ND-YAG laser capsulotomy is costly procedure and almost equal cost than cataract surgery. It was an honor for me after doing a walk with Dr. David Apple to write a complete issue of survey ophthalmology on elimination of cataract blindness, a global perspective entering new millennium. This study on 5,416 pseudophakic eyes, human eyes obtained post-mortem, and they were analyzed by Miyake Apple view. And this showed that the incidence of the PCO and ND-YAG laser posterior capsulotomy rate were least with hydrophobic acrylic IOL. This is hydrophobic acrylic IOL, whereas it was much more with silicone and PMMA IOL. These were the two other paper on posterior capsular opacification and IOL decentration and PCO together. This study on 3,493 eyes, also studied by Miyake Apple view, showed that secure in the bag fixation of IOL produced least PCO. As you can see, this is in the bag placed IOL, least PCO. If we implant the IOL in the capsular bag, less PCO. If it is out of the bag, there may be more PCO, as well as you cannot achieve optimal visual outcome. This is still another study show on 3,320 pseudophakic human eyes obtained post-mortem, and they were studied by Miyake Apple view. This is a posterior view of the while we evaluate the PCO by the posterior view, and it showed that cortical cleanup significantly reduce or eliminate incidence of PCO. As you can see here, that there is a sombering ring formation, and if cortex is nicely taken out at the time of surgery, rate of the PCO will go down. These are the now comes to clinical study. These are clinical study which we have done in 2001, this was on 278 eyes. It was seen that when IOL is implanted in the capsular bag, 11.9% PCO, although with PMMA it was more, silicone it was more, but hydrophobic acrylic IOL it was less, whereas out of the bag it was much more. So it showed that in the bag fixation of IOL significantly reduced PCO compared to out of the bag. This is another study, clinical study, on 340 consecutive patients who underwent phacoemulsification and IOL implantation, showed that PCO rates were 6.5% with hydrophobic acrylic IOL compared to 21 and 26% with PMMA and silicone IOL. This is the study which is done in 2009, and it showed less PCO rate because all the IOLs were square edge IOL. So it means that implantation of square edge IOL, whether it is PMMA, silicone or other hydrophobic acrylic IOL, had less PCO, although it may be much more with the PMMA IOL compared to hydrophobic acrylic IOL. But in uveitis, it may not be so because inflammation may play a role. Chances of uveitis may be as high as 28.7%. This is a study which we have published in Journal of Cataract and Refractive Surgery. But in pediatric, it is not so. If we do not do primary posterior capsulotomy and anterior vitrectomy, there may be higher chances of PCO. So it is the management of the posterior capsule rather than IOL designs and material that influence the PCO. This is the clear visual axis after implantation of IOL and doing primary posterior capsulotomy. This is another study showing that when we do primary posterior capsulotomy, it does not matter whether it is a PMMA IOL or a square edge PMMA IOL or acrylic IOL, there were similar PCO rates in children. This is a study which we published in British Journal of Ophthalmology, showed that in less than 6 years we did primary posterior capsulotomy, and rate of PCO were significantly reduced even then, in spite of doing primary posterior capsulotomy and anterior vitrectomy. If you follow these children for a long time, then they may have almost 16 to 20% PCO rate. This is just to show that how important it is to do a meticulous surgery in pediatric. This is after doing capsulotomy. This is hydro dissection. And this is a multi-quadrant hydro dissection. And this is phacoaspiration, not phacoemulsification, because no energy is required for emulsification of pediatric cataract. And then we have to remove this cortex very nicely, because it is important to remove the total cortical material. And this is performing primary posterior capsulotomy. And size we keep such that we can implant the IOL into capsular bag. This is the posterior capsulotomy, then implanting IOL into capsular bag. This second instrument is blunt and it can be rotated into capsular bag nicely. And whatever vitreous and whatever cortical material, that has to be nicely removed. And this is another in adult, that how it important it is to remove cortical material from the capsular bag. This is in adult. And there is a lot of lens epithelial cells lining the posterior capsule, lining the anterior capsule, and it is difficult to remove 100% of it, but you can do whatever is accessible. And such as here there is these lens epithelial cells, but because equatorial are more important, so it is impractical to remove all the lens epithelial cell. And this is a little cortex here, and at least to best of your satisfaction, you have to remove this cortex and then implant IOL into capsular bag. Then implanting square edge IOL into capsular bag and keeping good coverage of the IOL by the capsular axis. This is a square edge IOL implanted into capsular bag. This is Alcon axis of IOL. And removal of the viscoelastic nicely. This is a just sealed capsule irrigation device of Anthony Maloof, that how this irrigation and how removal of the lens epithelial cells from the capsular bag help to reduce the PCO, and practically how much it is possible to do it. And this is how important is size and centration of the rexis. This is the rexis, and IOL is covered at least 1 millimeter around. Another case, this is within the bag IOL, this is out of the bag. If it is out of the bag, same IOL, it is within the bag, no PCO. If it is out of the bag, then there will be sulcus fixated IOL, should not be implanted into sulcus. Then how much is the PCO, it can be seen. Least maximum contact between the IOL optic and posterior capsule, as it is seen here. And this is how these lens epithelial cell migrate from the equatorial area. As it can be seen here, that how this round edge IOL PCO formation take place here. This is a round edge IOL. How these lens epithelial cells come from the equatorial area and go behind. And they are flattened once they go behind the optic of the IOL. And while they pile up in the periphery, they form Sommering ring. Here they form PCO. And this is the example, that this is a round edge IOL, very nice surgery done, and there is a PCO because it is a round edge IOL. This is another, that how this barrier effect is produced by square edge IOL. This is a square edge IOL, this is square edge. Now most of the IOL, and how these lens epithelial cells comes and they migrate, but they are stopped here. This is the photograph which I have taken from my patients, where all the photographs are from my study, not from any other study. So this is a square edge IOL, and these lens epithelial cells are stopped here. Then this is to show that how this square edge IOL help to prevent PCO. These are another patients having less showing the square edge effect, and this is the Miyake apple view showing a clear visual axis, because these lens epithelial cells are stopped in the periphery and they form the Sommering ring. Hydrophobic acrylic IOL, they are very very compatible and help to reduce PCO. This is again hydrophobic acrylic IOL with clear visual axis. This single piece hydrophobic acrylic IOL. But still, if you see these patients for long time, there may be some other factor. There is a little PCO. Here these are hydrophilic acrylic IOL. I have found more PCO in these patients, except Acreos advanced optic. More PCO. This is thin optic IOL or thin IOL. How much PCO? High rate of PCO. Technis acrylic. This is a multifocal IOL. Again, from three side PCO in when design is faulty. Fluorid PCO. PCO in multifocal IOL. How much damage to IOL optic during surgery? During NDR laser capsulotomy. ACO and PCO may coexist. This is just IOL opacification, which may simulate PCO. and sometime they may diagnose this IOL opacification as cataract. This simulate just like zonular cataract. So in conclusion, our study performed on the largest laboratory database of the world on human eyes, on so many eyes, provided us insight of the mechanism and pathogenesis of PCO. Our clinical study showed that in the bag, implantation of IOL significantly reduced PCO as well as ND-YAG laser capsulotomy rate. Patients with uveitis have higher rate of PCO. We found that hydrophobic acrylic IOL has least PCO compared to PMMA and silicone and hydrophilic acrylic IOL. Most importantly, square edge IOL design reduced PCO irrespective of the IOL material. In pediatric surgery, it was management of the capsule which was effective in reducing PCO than the IOL material and design. Thank you very much.